everybody. Hello. And as you can see, lots of work's been done. Not just on the world itself, but on how it looks. I hope you like it. I've been experimenting with a combination of different texture packs and shaders and whatnot. And yeah, I've come up with this, and I'm really happy with the look. Really, really, really happy. And also, yeah, I guess I should show you what I've been doing, because it's been ages since you guys have caught along. I've gained quite a few I've gained quite a lot of few subscribers from the tech videos I've been doing. I think the last time I looked at it, I was nearly at 500, so perhaps I'll be at 500 now. And rain! Great! It's exactly what I wanted. So for those of you who haven't looked at this before, this is the beginnings of my base. Yeah. Exciting, right? And yeah, so this is a big, I think it's like 128, I think, or is it 256? I can't remember. I think that it's 256 in diameter, circle. And I've dug it down to that height, which I can't remember now. I'll go down and press F3 and we'll take a look at it soon. So yeah, what do you think of the shaders, guys? I'm using a Cel-Shaded shader, which Dave helped me get set up because I was finding it kind of tough to do because it's not that apparent, actually. Still a bit buggy, as you can see. You can sort of see the lines through my hand. That definitely wasn't in existence in, like, old versions of the shader, but it's around, but I don't really care enough. I think it looks so cool that I'm going to stick around with it, and we'll see if it gets fixed. But yeah, and I'm also using, I think it's the Summerfield texture pack. The links to both of these things will be in the description, as always, guys. So yeah, please don't spam the comments with that sort of stuff. Well, you can if you want, but I'm not going to answer you. And I'm trying to endeavor to answer as many comments as I possibly can. So yeah, so I dug it all out, drained everything, took an absolute age. Oh yeah, and of course, the thing you haven't noticed, I've also done a lot of the walls for glass. I think I'm going to go down to glass with this until this height, and I've done most of it. I just kept going. And these are the resources I've had. You might look at this space and you think, wow, you'll have tons of resources. And I definitely have quite a few resources. But when you think about it, there's actually most of it is just water. So, wow, that thunder looks cool with the cell shading, doesn't it? So most of it's just one. I'm just going to put this away so that you don't look at it again. Most of it's still, most of it was water, so whilst we've got, you know, quite a lot, it's not an absolute ton. So it's cobble. Yeah, here's some of my tools. Oh yeah, I've done this all with stone tools, because I'm a bit of a crazy person and I want to save my iron, which is not in the iron chests because I've been smelting it, and it should all be in the I don't think I've got all these furnaces. I've got all these furnaces filled up with coal, but I think only some of them have all the iron in it, but we'll move that over in a second. Just to show you some of the stuff I've got. Yeah, it's just two chests of cobble. Sand, some sand, iron, glass, more sand, and that's the rest of the coal I have, and that's the clay. But I got quite a lot of clay, so I think I'll be doing some stuff with the bricks. And this is all dirt. And actually, there's some of the stuff that I brought over from before. I haven't had to eat a single piece of food yet, which I'm slightly worried about because I've been playing on peaceful. I haven't gone off peaceful since I started building. You can call me a coward if you want, but that's okay because soon I'll be taking it off peaceful, and then we will never be going back. Whoa, did anyone see the lightning come down into the base? Oh, that's awesome. I'll definitely be trying to get some pirate creepers whenever I set up some sort of system. Anyway, so what we're going to do today is go for more resources. We've got quite a lot of iron, but we'll probably get some iron whenever we go down for it. I don't know if you noticed when I was up there, but I've sort of left little dirt things around any entrances to caves or ravines that I saw. So, what's this? I'm like, yeah, these are just some of the rest of the stone tools. Crafting bench. I think that's got wood and shit in it, yeah. Yeah, it's just like my really simple tree farm. So yeah, I really should have started going now because I like going into caves at night, and because it means that there's less there's less spawns because it's so dark up above that there's lots of mobs spawning up above. Although saying that, I am in an ocean biome, so I don't know how that's going to affect that. I'll probably be absolutely inundated. Is that everything? I think it is. I probably should refill some of that coal, but I can't be bothered. But yeah, but what I basically am looking for when I'm going down here is redstone, maybe some more iron, but definitely some diamond. So in the meantime, going to make ourselves some armor because that's pretty important. As I said, I'm going to be going off peaceful. Definitely going to die an absolute ton. So yeah, let's get this armor on us. Wonder what it looks like. Oh, I look pretty snazzy. Quite like the look of that. Oh, it looks really good in the cell shading. I am really digging this shader. I just think Minecraft looks so good as a cartoon, you know? I'm a big fan of Borderlands, so anything like that's awesome. Let me get some of these sticks, and we'll make ourselves some tools. What do we need? I'll give myself 2 iron pickaxes. 2 iron shovels. And 1 iron sword. No, 2 iron swords. Just in case. So there's the pickaxe. There's the iron pickaxe. I'm gonna take a few more stone pickaxes. I've got some stone pickaxes. I'll put these axes away. Buckets. Need some buckets for water. Well, that's pretty cool. This is the first time I've really played through this texture pack, guys. I was building a lot in default, but this is the first. This is the first time I've really played through. I think it looks really good. I think it looks good, but it also looks kind of unique, which is something I'm really happy with because I'd love to have, you know, a certain look that goes along with my my let's play. 1 bucket should be enough. Let's go. Right. Should really make some ladders. Torches! I need more torches. I think the coal's up here, isn't it? And, yeah. I'll take a stack with me. And let me just take a stack of these sticks. Put this back. Take a stack. And, I don't want to shift-click because I don't want a full stack full of this. But here we go. I'll take them with me. I'm kind of anal about organizing my shit, guys. Sorry about that. Will I take that iron with me? No, I don't want to lose it. There's a decent chance I'll die. And I also want to take this stick. And you know what? Before I go, I should set up some seeds, shouldn't I? Oh, feck that. Couldn't be arsed with that. Let me put that stick in my hotbar. Plenty of room for minerals. Okay, let's do this. Should I take some building blocks? I'll take some dirt. Take a stack of dirt. I'll probably pick up a lot on the way, but, you know, better to be safe than sorry. So, here we go. Right, which one will we go down first? Yeah, the reason I'm doing this on camera is because you guys mentioned that you actually like hearing me talk, doing all that nonsense, so, sounds good. I don't know if you guys know this trick. I use it all the time for getting down into these ravines. Haven't really had a look down here yet. Okay, well this looks disappointing, but we'll get what we can. It's just the stone one, yeah. Cool. So, I'm glad you guys have been enjoying. Have I got any? Oh, I didn't bring any. Oh well, whatever. See, I'm such a pedantic person. I don't like using iron unless I absolutely have to. which is so silly because I've got so much of it now. I think I'll eventually get to the stage where I'm just sort of like using it willy-nilly, but not quite yet. I'm going to take this coal as well. What did I ask? Yeah, have you guys been enjoying the Tekkit? if you, especially the change we made, we picked up on you guys not really digging the whole cheating thing, which we weren't going to do very much of, to be honest, guys. I'm just sort of exploring, by the way, just to see if this is going to be a bigger ravine. I don't think it is. Awesome. Well, not awesome, obviously, but... So, yeah, we picked up on the fact that you guys probably preferred a slightly more legitimate... a legitimate playthrough, and that's totally cool. So, yeah, if you watch Dave's latest video, which most of you probably have, because, as I said, I'm very aware that most of my subscribers come from Dave, you'll see that... Ugh, this damn rain, man! Ugh, you'll notice that most... we've made some changes in that regard, for sure, and, ooh, lava. Right. Sorry, I was just thinking about getting another bucket. Let's just take a look to see if this goes anywhere. I would absolutely kill to die right now. I would... That doesn't make sense. I really... Ooh, bugger, what is this? Is that gravel? Oh, I shouldn't be standing on this! Says he as he digs his way out of it. Let's hope for the best. I can actually use this gravel to make it a little bit safer. Is there anything here anyway? It doesn't look like there is. God, it'd be a real bummer if all these ravines I find were actually a complete and utter waste. Is that flint? Awesome. What was I talking about? Sorry for this appalling commentary right now. What the hell was I talking about? I honestly have just gone a complete mind blank and have completely forgotten what I was talking about. Was it about Tekkit? Anyway, whatever. Yeah, so that's basically what we're doing. We're going to go a little bit more legitimate, and obviously we can't all play it together at the same time, so if we got any footage of us separately playing, then we'll record it. Ooh, this looks more promising, eh? This looks... Ow. God. This looks more promising. So yeah, that's cool. I'm enjoying it, for sure. It's big, though, guys. It's pretty, intimidating. Every time I go onto the wiki to try and like look stuff up, I just get overwhelmed and kind of, well, not bored, but a little bored, I guess. I mean, it's just so much stuff to redstone, brilliant, to like read that, you know, it's sometimes not really worth the hassle. But especially whenever you can just sort of like, oh, I completely forgot. Right, I'm going to go for normal. I'm not that much of a hardcore guy to go on hard, but this is it. That's it. Now, normal forever. So, quickly light this up. Oh, that's not redstone. Well, that's disappointing. Quickly light this shit up. Let's take a quick look around. I'm really digging this texture pack. Gives it a completely unique feel. Get these mushrooms. Mushroom stew will be a decent source of food. Gold, I believe? Which is cool. In fact, this gold has just reminded me of something. I'm currently in talks, guys, with a modder who is possibly doing a mod for me. And let me explain this mod. I love mods, but for this playthrough I'm going to try and avoid them at all possible, especially in the ones that will affect gameplay. I'm not going to use, like, you know, inventory hacks and stuff like that there. What I might do, as you can see, though, is use mods like texture packs and shit. Fuck. Oh, that's the first zombie I've heard in a long time in this world. Whew. Yeah, shaders and stuff to, like, improve the overall feel of the game. And that's basically what I've contacted this guy about, because many of you who've watched the videos before will probably have heard you mention that I want to set up an arc. I think that's what I'm going to call it, the arc, or something. to that effect. And can I get that torch through there? And in order to do that, I realized that mobs are going to despawn, especially if I leave the area like I'm doing now. I don't exactly know the complete details of it, but, you know, if I catch a creeper, put it in a hole, go away, it's not going to be there, I'm going to be pretty pissed off. So what I basically thought of is contacting a modder to see if he can help me get mobs to behave a little bit more like passive mobs. Not all of them, obviously, because that would obviously create a lag fest. So something that allowed me to adapt and modify a certain mobs, you know, like allow me to catch certain mobs and to render them non-despawnable, should we say it? Should we call it? And the reason the gold reminded me of that is because we were talking about maybe making it fair to gameplay, have an apple that does it for regular mobs, although to be fair most regular mobs don't despawn, but just in case things like wolves and cats and stuff, if their behavior ever gets changed, do stuff like that there. So you have to feed them an item like an apple to do that, and for dangerous mobs, for hostile mobs, creepers, zombies, skeletons and stuff, have to use a golden apple, which I kind of like the idea of because it's kind of like keeps it fair to gameplay, I guess, and just something I was looking for. I don't want it to be a complete hack. I want to be able to select a mob and make sure that mob doesn't despawn, as opposed to, ooh, lapis. Can I use a stone on lapis? Yes. Ooh, that looks fancy. Whoa, that was silly. That was sillier. Right. So yeah, let me see, there must be more. You don't get like veins that are only too big for lapis, do you? Aha, always worth a look. Always worth a look. I think somebody recently put a post on Reddit actually detailing how veins work with, I think all veins work differently. Maybe iron and coal work the same from just experience and anecdotal experience. They look as if they work the same, but I don't know. I know that iron veins are always bigger than diamond, not always, but often bigger than diamond veins. Get my sword out. Just use dirt for this, I think. Come on, go away. Come on! Awesome. Getting dark. I want to get lower. So yeah, hopefully that mob will be up and running soon, and then we can start working on our arc, which I'm really excited about. I've got lots of ideas for builds. Oh, I'm using my iron. I've got lots of ideas for builds, but that's one of the ones I'm most excited about, to be utterly honest. And more gold, yay. Because it's going to be very fun, I reckon, and it'll be something unique, and it'll be something that'll be fun to watch me trying to catch these. And also, as I mentioned before, I thought I might link it with any donation service I set up. I actually have set up a donation service now through PayPal. I am not expecting anyone to donate, guys. There's no obligation to donate whatsoever, but basically I'm having... Although I might not look it, although you're probably thinking, wow, this guy's running a... I think it's 64x64. Well, whatever. He's running a HD texture pack, he's running a shader, and he's not getting any significant FPS problems. And that's true, I'm not getting FPS problems, but I'm getting big, big lag spikes every now and again. Particularly when I do certain things at the same time when recording, which can be quite problematic for recording. And... it basically sometimes means I have to do things more than once, which is very frustrating, because you get these big, massive breaks in recording simply because... Just make sure nothing spawns down here. Oh, am I getting hungry soon? Where is that noise coming from? Probably over here. Which is, you know, not ideal. And that means there's often delays in getting the videos out, which again, is not ideal. And I want to stop that as much as possible. And in order to do that, it would be great if I could make some money out of this that I would obviously put straight back into the YouTube channel. The thing I'm looking for at most at the moment is more RAM. I've only got 4 gig of RAM, which isn't an awful lot for a computer, actually. I actually, when I was originally building this computer, I bought 8 gig, and 4 of the gigs were faulty. And I only confirmed this. Well, I was pretty sure they were faulty because I went through and I was troubleshooting the computer as I built it, and the only thing that would get it to work was if I took out these particular 2 gigs of RAM. And I, at one stage, I thought maybe the power supply isn't enough, but no, because it was these particularly. It was this particular 2 sticks, and fuck Stark. And I basically isolated it down to these, so I'm pretty sure it was faulty. But I only recently, which is, you know, totally my fault, I only recently took it to mobs. I haven't seen any of these mob skins. This is exciting. I need to stop being so cavalier. Where's that skelly? Come on, I haven't got a bow. I just realized about all the flint that I had. But I don't have feathers. But I've got plenty of flint because of all that gravel. So it should feck. Alright, concentrate, 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 concentrate. Gotta get that skelly. Gotta get these both skellies. Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh my god.